We look forward to your visit to the Mare Island Museum. The visit will place you in a National Historic Landmark and the oldest building on the first United States Naval Base on the Pacific Coast. The building was constructed as a smithery under the direction of Mare Island's first commandant, Admiral David Glasgow Farragut. The museum is the heart of the former Naval Shipyard, where hundreds of thousands of men and women spent generations servicing and building our nation's Navy. The decision to build the shipyard had its roots in 1848, when, following the Mexican-American War, a vast tract of land that included present-day California was granted to the United States. Coincidentally, gold was discovered at Sutter's Fort less than a week earlier. Those two events set off a massive migration to a coast that was totally unfortified and separated by mountains and deserts from the administrative and military power of the government. The only shipyards were on the East Coast, and it was clear that a Navy shipyard was needed in California. In 1852, Rear Admiral John Drake Sloat was charged with selecting a site for such a shipyard somewhere in the San Francisco Bay Area. His team selected a barren island in the North Bay, and the island was purchased on January 4, 1853. Meanwhile, back east, the Secretary of the Navy was meeting with Commander David Glasgow Farragut, who was selected to construct and command this important new Pacific Coast facility. Farragut arrived on Mare Island on September 16, 1854, to take command of what consisted of a few squatter shacks and a government-owned sectional floating dry dock. The dry dock was constructed and shipped around Cape Horn on clipper ships. Farragut was carrying a plan for the new shipyard, referred to as the Sanger Plan. He was given the plan by Navy headquarters as his guidance for the construction of the new shipyard. When you enter the museum, you are in the former smithery shown on the Sanger Plan. As a smithery, this building contained more than 50 coal-fired forges and steam-driven hammers that were used to create the wrought iron fittings required for the naval vessels of the period. The use of the building evolved over time, and by World War II it was a pipe shop equipped with over 200 machine tools employing 3,100 workers. Those same tools would eventually be used to construct piping systems required for nuclear-powered submarines. In the early days, the building was one of the largest structures available on the island, and it was used for social events as well as for its function as a smithery. Captain Farragut often walked the museum spaces as he was busy constructing the many buildings and housing needed to forge the shipyard envisioned in the Sanger Plan from the remote island. 4 years after arrival, Admiral Farragut departed Mare Island and went on to Civil War fame, where he famously exclaimed, "Damn the torpedoes, full speed ahead," at the Battle of Mobile Bay. In the years Captain Farragut commanded Mare Island, it grew to a bustling shipyard, complete with a floating dry dock, storehouses, a sawmill, and officers' housing, all arrayed around the museum. We hope you enjoy the opportunity afforded by the museum to view one of the largest non-federal collections of official U.S. Navy artifacts anywhere. The USS Mariana G. Vallejo was decommissioned in 1993 after 29 years of service during the height of the Cold War. You will find numerous actual components from the submarine on display in this museum.